Well, good afternoon. I would like all of you to look at my sweater and figure out how many different colors there are in it. Now I want you to flex the toes on your left foot and notice how the small toe, how the tiniest toe feels. Listen to my voice. Am I a tenor or a baritone? Now take a second and wonder, what in the world is your speaker doing with this introductory paragraph? Well, I'll tell you what I'm doing. Everything you have just sensed, thought, done, moving your feet, looking at my sweater, seeing my sweater, counting colors, wondering what I'm doing, it is all, as far as we can tell, the product of the firings of neurons in your brain. That's actually a very disconcerting idea for many of us, at least it has been for me, that my entire mental universe is nothing more or less than packets of neurotransmitters being given off by some neurons, or occasionally glial cells, and picked up by other neurons, and that generates my mind and the universe that my mind lives in. But as far as we can tell, that's all there is. And if that's right, the revolution in neuroscience, the revolution in understanding of the brain and how the brain works, will inevitably lead to enormous changes in how we understand each other, how we deal with each other, and how our society functions. Because our society is a society not of human bodies, but of human brains. When we interact with people, we may think we're interacting with their bodies, and we may interact with their bodies to some extent, but when we decide how to treat people, when we decide how to teach people, when we decide who to jail and who not to jail, ultimately we are making those decisions based on brains, not bodies, to the extent we understand better how those brains work. Those decisions are going to change, and with it will change our society.